This is Solar PVTV once again from Race for Africa event here in Ethiopia, in Addis Ababa. And now we are together with David Lecoq, who is Policy and Business Development Manager at Alliance for Rural Electrification. And for me, it's always, you know, like a touching moment, yes, when I speak with the guys from the Alliance, because like a lot of years ago, I was helping to the president, Mr. Ernesto Macias, so thumbs up for Ernesto.
Thumbs up, Ernesto.
To create the basics, you know, the fundamentals of the Alliance. And today, actually, Alliance is a very successful organization. It's also a partner of this event. But, you know, I don't want to speak too much. Yeah, I would like to just ask you, what brings you here, David, to the event?
Well, what brings me here to this event is that, well, of course, Race for Africa being one of the key partners these days of ARE, which indeed, maybe to recall, is the Global Business Association for Decentralized Renewable Energy Actors that bring about clean energy access in the rural areas of developing countries. Yes, I'm of course here in my role as a policy and business development person for the ARE to support our partners, to showcase also this event towards the rest of the industry, because certainly we have a common mission and a common view. Which is to achieve universal electricity access, or rather access to energy, and we are both bringing together the companies who at the end of the day are the energy access delivery service, if I can put it like this.
Exactly. I remember that, you know, when we are creating Alliance, it was more like hobby of Ernesto, yes, because it was so small market and he was so believing in the future. And today I think that situation completely changed, yes?
Yeah, the situation, of course, we were founded in 2006, so the situation is very different from back in the day, because also, well, renewables have become much more important, and I would dare say even the topic of access to energy has in the last 5 to 10 years gained a lot of importance. So associations being a bit of a mirror image of the sector, well, at the time we had a few members, it was a bit... Yeah, in the beginning it was
like a hobby,
professional, but it was already professional, but it's true that it professionalized further. And now we are nearly at 130 members, and not just from Europe, but also, and more, but from Africa, from Asia, from Latin America.
So and truly global.
Truly global, across the green technologies, and across the system sizes, from the really pico things up to larger mini-grids. And our role has also been refined in the way that now the two main pillars of action in a way are that we remain a partner with the public sector in particular to help design the right framework conditions for the sector to flourish so that we can get energy access done, that is the mission, and that we also of course help them, the companies that constitute ARE, in their project development, giving them
a lot more business.
To make more business, because it's simple. The more business they do, the more energy access that is happening.
Mm-hmm. And I would like to ask you about storage, yes? Because
please.
In 2006, storage was, you know, extremely expensive, yes? And not so accessible like today. And mm-hmm. How do you observe from the perspective of Alliance, how the storage is, you know, helping, you know, in realization of more and more of making, let's say, off-grid like a mainstream?
Yes, that is. Well, storage is not just for our sector or our segment, but for the entire renewable energy sector. Of course, the niche, the key to really make it the biggest thing. There has been a lot, as you know, of evolution, of innovation in storage. Costs have come down, especially also batteries, but they have not come down enough. So the challenge will be, right now it's really interesting because you see a bit of a race between different storage technologies, batteries, but also other types of storage. It's going to be interesting to see who's going to win the day at the end. But whatever it is, it needs to be a solution that, in the case of rural electrification of developing countries, is adapted to the local context. Because without that, projects just will never work, and then our goal of energy access will not be realized. So storage is... something where a lot of innovation is happening right now. We're very excited, and we encourage all the companies to keep pushing, to keep investing in R&D, so that we can get this at the end of the day final piece of the puzzle, not just energy access, but for renewable energy in general, done.
So, what about your plans? I'm not speaking about your personal plans here, because your agenda is made on the daily basis. Yes. But what are the plans and milestones? For the next 1, 2, 3 years to come for Alliance?
Yes, I think the Alliance, the idea and the strong objective is that we continue on our a very strong growth path. I mean, already this year we have added 20 or 30 more companies to our membership base, so that we keep growing along with the sector, that we keep being the number one reference point with the public sector to come and sit down and see what we can do to help the public sector achieve the objective of energy access. So this is really the main activities. And moving more specifically, I think we have set up working groups recently on the geographical level, so for Africa, Asia, Latin America, and some thematic ones. And the idea is that we really move from not just being very relevant, if I may say so, on the international and the regional level, but also more and more directly on the national level. Who knows, maybe we have some physical presence inside our target countries or so. Let's see how we're going to go about it, but this objective of going into the countries to be relevant on the national level is certainly something that is very important in our goals in the next 1 to 3 years.
Okay, so the last question, please. About cooperation with Race for Africa, because you are mentioning that you are going to have some concrete stuff together, yes, next year.
Yes, indeed. And in next week, we will make an announcement about a common activity that we will be doing. So if you haven't subscribed yet to our newsletters on the website of Race for Africa and ARE, I strongly encourage you to do so, because there will be some common activities and some even stronger synergies in moving forward, so to say, to really bring the industry together.
Okay, so thank you so much. That was Solar PVTV with David Lecoq, who is working for Alliance for Rural Electrification, one of the partners of Race for Africa. And unfortunately, he couldn't, you know, disclose, yeah?
But
at the end of the day, at least you will visit the website of Race for Africa and of Alliance next week for a big announcement.
And a big thumbs up for Race for Africa.
Yes, exactly. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.